Greetings, friends. David Marks here. It's October, and the latest version of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic has just been released. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to upgrade to the latest version, the 13th version of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic. With a little guidance, the whole upgrade process should be pretty easy for you, but there are some pitfalls, so please be careful and take your time if you're playing along with this tutorial. Before we jump into a step-by-step guide to the upgrade process, I need to point out two important details. First, to run Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic version 13, your computer must meet Adobe's updated system requirements. For Mac users, this means that your computer must be running OS X version 12 or something more recent. For Windows users, your computer must be using the Windows version 10 2022 H2 operating system or something more recent like Windows 11 to install this upgrade. Next, I'm going to assume that you already have an up-to-date backup of your current Lightroom catalog and of all your images before you begin the Lightroom Classic version 13 upgrade process. If you need more advice on how to back up all of your images and your Lightroom catalog, then please follow one of my in-depth tutorials on this critical topic before you begin to install this upgrade. With these warnings out of the way, let's start with a quick peek inside of my existing Lightroom Classic catalog. What we need to know before we start the Classic version 13 upgrade process is the name of your current Lightroom catalog and exactly where your .lrcat file lives inside of your computer. The easiest way to find this information out on a Mac is to go up to the words Lightroom Classic on the menu bar at the top of the screen and then down to the Catalog Settings option. Windows users, you will find the exact same button at the bottom of your Edit menu. Once you've opened up the Catalog Settings menu, you'll see something like this. In this block, Lightroom Classic displays the exact file path through your computer to this catalog file. We're going to ask Classic to show us where this catalog lives in just a second, but this info, the path to your catalog and its exact name, those are important details, so please write this stuff down if needed. When you're ready to reveal the location of your current catalog, please click on the Show in Finder button on a Mac or the Show in Explorer button on a PC. When you tap on this button, an operating system window will appear. I strongly suggest that you move this window off to the side of your screen, but don't close it. Next, you can click back into Classic, and you can close out of the Catalog Settings box. Now that we know the name and exact file path for this Lightroom catalog, you need to quit or completely exit out of Lightroom Classic. To install the Lightroom Classic version 13 upgrade, you need to open up the Adobe Creative Cloud app. On a Mac, you can probably find this icon up here near the top right corner of your screen. PC folks, you should be able to find the same icon near the bottom right corner of your screen on the Windows Quick Launch bar. If you can't find this app in either place, then first make sure that you're connected to the internet, and then go inside your computer in the Programs or Applications folder and look for something like this, Adobe Creative Cloud. Once you're inside of the Creative Cloud app, we need to make sure that you're signed in to your Adobe Creative Cloud account. And now, we can tap here where it says Check for Updates. Once your screen looks like this, then tap here to start the Lightroom Classic version 13 upgrade process. At this point, the latest version of the Lightroom Classic program will begin to download and install. While version 13 is downloading, let me remind you that each version of Lightroom Classic uses a different catalog format. Installing the program is only one step in the complete process, And once the new software has been installed, then we'll need to upgrade our Lightroom catalog. If you only have one Lightroom catalog, then that step, the catalog upgrade process, is something that you will only need to do once and life is easy. If for some reason you've decided to add extra complexity into your life by working with multiple Lightroom catalogs, then you're going to have to repeat the catalog upgrade step that we are about to start again and again for each of your classic catalogs. Now that the program has been upgraded, we can tap on the Open button here beside the words Lightroom Classic. At this point, you should see a box asking to confirm that this is indeed the catalog that you want to upgrade. Assuming that Classic has found the right catalog, then this window will also show us something else that's important. Do you see here where it's going to append V13 onto the end of my new catalog's name? Finally, after years of confusion, Adobe is trying to make it clear that when you upgrade from one version of Classic to another, that your Lightroom catalog is going to be duplicated and the new version will be renamed. What they're trying to tell you is that your new catalog and all of its helper monkey files will have -V13 added onto the end of their file names. Now that you're aware of what's about to happen, I'm going to hit the upgrade button. This step might take a while, so please be patient, especially if you have a very large catalog with thousands and thousands of images. Most tutorials would call the upgrade process complete at this point, but there are two more steps that I find very helpful. First, I want to delete a couple of extraneous files that the upgrade process left behind. The easiest way to find those orphan files is to go back to the catalog settings menu. I'll go to General again, and I'll tap Show. Once this window appears, I'm going to move it aside, but I'm not going to close it once again. Now, I'm going to click back into Lightroom, and I'm going to quit completely out of the program. In this window, you can see that there are now two separate lrcat files. This causes a lot of confusion, so let me explain why Adobe did this. Adobe intentionally left the old lrcat file, the one I was using in the version 12 days, untouched for two reasons. First, they left this file alone, so that if something were to go terribly wrong, then I could start the whole catalog upgrade process all over again. Second, they left this file unchanged because Lightroom Classic catalogs are not backwards compatible. I can't think of any reason why you would want to downgrade and go back to version 12. But if for some reason you needed to do that, then we would absolutely need this old file. And so what I'm going to suggest is let's tuck it away. I'm going to put it up here in my backups folder so that I'll have it if I need it, but it won't cause any further confusion. Next, I'm going to delete these two leftover helper files. If you're playing along, be sure to delete only the old helper.lrdata and old .lrcat.data files. Be sure that you do not accidentally delete anything that has the new -V13 tag added onto the end of its file name. Finally, I'm going to double-click on my -V13 catalog to relaunch the program. Once Classic loads, the last step in the upgrade process is to go into the Preferences menu. Once the Preferences menu opens, let's go to the General tab, and where it says Startup, let's be sure that the catalog that we just upgraded, the one with the V13 at the end of its name, is now the startup default. If you take the time to do this step, then this catalog, and only this catalog, should open automatically whenever you launch the new program. For most Lightroom users, we're done at this point, but I have one last tip to share here for those of you who've been following my video for many years. For my longtime listeners, you may recall that I like to use an alias or a shortcut rather than the generic program icon when I start up Lightroom Classic. If I've helped you with this process at one of my workshops, or if you've followed this advice from one of my video tutorials, then we need to update our catalog shortcut as well. To make a new alias, to make one that leads to this new Classic version 13 catalog, I'm going to open up the catalog settings menu one more time. And here, I'm going to go to the General tab, and I'm going to tap on that Show in Finder or Show in Explorer button. Once again, I'm going to leave this window alone, but I'm not going to close it. Next, I can click back into Lightroom Classic. I can close or quit out of the program. And at this point, if you have an alias or a shortcut like this one on your desktop or here in your dock, we need to delete it. You can delete those files without any fear because those were shortcuts that led to your old Lightroom Classic version 12 catalog. And once they're gone, we need to replace them. To do that, I'm going to go into the folder where my new catalog lives, and then I'm going to right-click on my .lrcat file. When this menu appears, I'm going to choose the Make Alias option. On a PC, choose the Create a Shortcut button. Now, I can drag my new alias out to the desktop, or I can pin it down here on a Mac on this side of the dock. We'll know that this process was a success if you double-click on your new alias and if your freshly upgraded Lightroom Classic version 13 catalog immediately opens. Well, there you go. At this point, the Lightroom Classic version 13 upgrade process is complete, and now you're ready to learn more about what's new in the latest release. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.